Staying on top of breaking news in Fort Myers, an armed man who barricaded himself inside a home early this morning is now dead.
At one point, two people were trapped inside that home with him.
She didn't think he had this kind of, you know, capabilities.
The shooting started at 2 a.m. near Grand Avenue east of U.S. 41. The SWAT team tried to get the man out, dodging gunfire from the suspect throughout the day.
NBC2's Shannon Clow is live from that neighborhood where the lockdown finally ended.
Peter and Kelly, I just spoke with the Fort Myers police chief who says it is believed that that suspect died from a self-inflicted wound, but that's still under investigation, as is the home where all of this happened. From the sights and sounds.
I've lived off of Grand for about 3 or 4 years.
His old neighborhood has changed.
I've heard a few gunshots, 5 or 6.
James Ewald deciding to detour around this danger.
That's kind of scary. I don't know what, I'm not going that way.
The Fort Myers SWAT team surrounding a house on Grand Avenue. A man barricaded himself inside and two others.
And she called me this morning as I was watching the news to say that she was in that house.
He was texting one person trapped on the inside.
I know she was scared because she texted me. She said, pray for us.
Those prayers answered when police were able to get the two out safely.
I can't go down there and do nothing, but prayer for me is always, it's a worker, and obviously it works. She's alive.
A man stayed inside, firing guns as police tried getting him out.
We just want to talk this guy, you know, hopefully down and out and resolve this safely.
SWAT teams fully armed. Police tossed flashbangs at the home, asking over a loudspeaker for a safe ending.
But I hope it all works out and nobody gets hurt.
He, too, is relying on the power of prayer that changes will continue.
I just hope and pray for the best.
The Fort Myers police chief tells me that they are not releasing the name of the suspect who has died or his motive at this time. I'm live in Fort Myers, Shannon Clow, NBC2.
Tomorrow.